each and every one of you. There's been you have heard of that. So thank you very much for being here. On behalf of the Valdosta Board of Realtors, will the members of the Valdosta Board of Realtors please stand and be recognized? And I notice there are several tables, but will all the members of the Valdosta North Rotary Club please stand and be recognized? Thank you very much. Today we're here on behalf of partnerships and to show and express the benefits and advantages of partnerships. Just look around. Just being you as a result of the partnership between all the entities that are mentioned there today here. And in addition, of course, which you will hear about the Homebuilders Association and, of course, the Rotary Club. This venue today was put together by the Chamber and Turner Powell. A lot of work that goes into this, so if you would, please give a round of applause to Turner Powell. Let's give an applause to the staff in the kitchen for preparing a wonderful meal today. Valdosta North Rotary Club formed a partnership earlier this year with many of you and with a lot of the businesses in town and even reaching out to the local communities in other towns. This partnership allowed us to have our premier fundraiser and function for Valdosta North Rotary Club to recognize and honor the teachers of the year. The Lowndes County teachers and the Valdosta City School teachers comprise 22 different schools. And we recognize those that our Teacher Appreciation Dinner 60 days ago in October, well, I think the 3rd of October. And we awarded those teachers, the district teachers, and of course, the schools funds from the fundraiser. The fundraiser raised $56,000 for these children and these teachers to honor them for being selected as teachers of the year. Valdosta Rotary Club, in addition, is formed a partnership with a lot of you locally, which we're in the process of right now, collecting money for the Rotary Foundation. For those of you that may not be familiar with the Rotary Foundation, it is a worldwide foundation of the Rotary International, comprised of 1.2 million members. And in 1987, Rotary International embarked on a mission to help eradicate polio from the face of the earth. In 1987, there were 350,000 cases of polio worldwide. To show you how successful this program has been with Rotary, and with the Rotary members in this room participating, the cases this year so far of latest count were down to 12 cases. From 350,000 to 12 cases, that's a phenomenal job. Those cases are confined to the countries of Afghanistan, which has 7 cases, and Pakistan, which has 5 cases. In addition, Rotary International works with the World Health Organization for other medical issues of whales and African and other third world countries who have need of whales and fresh water and sanitary conditions. And this just goes to show what the benefits of partnership comprise. If you think about it, our country has survived many, many tragedies, but we've had many, many successes in the medical field. And it is amazing what you can do with partnership. At this time, I would like to introduce to you Professor of Music at Valdosta State University, Mr. Joe Mason, and he's accompanied by Ms. Susan Wheeler on the piano, and they will perform for us, Georgia on the line.
comes as sweet and clear as moonlight through the pines. Other arms reach out to me, other eyes smile tenderly. Still in peaceful dreams I see the road leads back to you. I said, Georgia, oh Georgia, no peace I find, just an old sweet song.
My name is Reg Joyner, and I'm proud to be the 2017 president of the Valdosta Board of Realtors. And they were introduced by Clarence just a moment ago, and I'm proud of the things that they have accomplished this year through various charitable causes, and also through our advocacy arm, which is the Realtors Political Action Committee. And we had a banner year. Set a goal of $18,000 or $17,000, and we beat that goal, actually reached $18,000. And that is for the Political Action Committee to meet with our legislatures, both local, statewide, and federal. And the primary goal of that RPAC is to protect private property ownership rights. And we are very proud of that and the things that have been accomplished. All of us that get up here and speak today for just real briefly want to emphasize the power that exists in the partnership of all of these organizations that are present here today. Most of you will remember Tip O'Neill, longtime Speaker of the U.S. House of Representatives. Now, Mr. O'Neill and I are definitely on opposite ends of the political spectrum, but he wrote a book in the mid-90s, and ironically, I really enjoyed that book. The book was entitled, All Politics is Local, and that is so true of us today. There is a chapter in that book. That chapter is entitled, Once You Get Power, Don't Be Afraid to Use It, No Matter How Big Your Opponent. And as was mentioned at our federal legislative luncheon, if we all stand together with one cause and one determination, we can do anything we want to do, at least locally. So So the partnership that is here today is vital. I want you also to know that there's a special group of young people with us today. I'd like to introduce them to the governor. These are members of the inaugural class of the Young Entrepreneurs Academy of Valdosta. These students are participating in a unique 30-week after-school program where they are learning how to start their own real business. When they graduate from Yale in May, most of them will have a business plan in one hand and a business license in the other hand. I'd like to ask these outstanding young people to stand and be recognized at this time. If you would, to stand for our invocation. Please bow with me. Our Father in heaven, we humbly come before your throne as a blessed people to live in this country, the greatest country on earth, blessed to be protected by members of our military, by our first responders, blessed to not even have to worry about things such as our daily sustenance. We are so thankful for the partnership that exists here today, the fellowship with these organizations, and we are thankful for the food that has been prepared. And we pray, Father, that as we go along, we always give thanks to you for sending your Son to die for our sins. For it is in the name of Jesus I pray. Amen. Please be seated. Now in a minute we're going to stand for the pledge, and I hate that you have to go up and down, but I think our country and our God are worth the respect necessary. I'd like to ask at this time, or introduce at this time, Franklin Bailey. He is the president of the Homebuilders Association of South Georgia. Right?
Well, that's a little bit of specialization I wasn't necessarily looking for, but I am Franklin Bailey. I am the current president of the local Homebuilders Association. I will tell you that you've already received a treat here today, because initially I was asked to sing a song today, but I declined that in order to stand before you this time. And Governor, good to see you here today. I will ask one question before I get started. If you have an extra seat or two, the Rose Bowl in your box, I will be happy to attend with you, sir. If I can have a Go Dogs, I'd appreciate that also. That's right. Again, as a general theme to be here today is power and partnerships. And as in the last couple of years, the Home Builder Association, along with the Chamber and also the Board of Realtors, have partnered on numerous events. Today, we're thankful that we can also come here and partner with the Valdosta Rotary to have participated in this legislative luncheon. And again, we're thankful for the opportunity to participate in this today. And as been said by Clarence and also by Reg, the Home Builder Association is not just a bunch of guys or gals building houses. It is a lot more than that. We locally, of course, we have numerous events throughout the year that we use as fundraisers for our local Home Builder Association. But in return, we take those and give back to needy organizations in town. And that is very rewarding to be able to do that. We, like I said, we do 3 or 4 events every year. So if we sometimes, you know, in the future knock on your door to ask you to participate in an event, you know, feel free to open your wallets and help us with these events. But also, we're talking about the Home Builder Association, the mission, like I said, it's just not building houses, which that's, at the end of the day, is where we all buy our groceries from and stuff. It's from our profits from building a house. But the mission locally, of course, is to educate builders here in town. We have numerous continuing education classes going on weekly and monthly for sure, to make sure that our builders are certified as they need to be going forward within the state guidelines. Also, of course, we have the state and the national level of the Homebuilders Association that truly are there helping us lobby against, I can say that other deal, lobby against some of the bills that come down to try to increase the pricing of homes and to make sure that homes stay affordable for each and every person. So it is local, state, and national is what the mission for the Homebuilders Association is. Governor, also have a special, also have a special recognition today, sir. We have a special group of young folks here today that are actually celebrating the 10th anniversary of the Valdosta Early College Academy, a.k.a. the VICA. It's one of the most successful early college academies in Georgia. It's a powerful partnership among the Valdosta State University, the Valdosta City Schools, and the Valdosta community. Today we have some VICA students and teachers and administrators and business sponsors. At this time, I'd like to ask the VICA table to stand as we congratulate you on your 10th anniversary. And an additional special recognition, I'd like to also recognize some of the Moody personnel that we have here today. Colonel Jennifer Short, Chief Master Sergeant Jerry Sebastian, Colonel Bradley Smith, Captain Carly Centauri, hope I did that right, Captain Elizabeth Gallagher, Master Sergeant Kurt Mitchell, and Staff Sergeant Josh Dunn, and also Parker and Lucy Green here today. If you will stand, let us give you a round of applause. Much for your service. It is only fitting at this time if I again ask each one of you to stand as we do pledge allegiance to our flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you much. You can be seated. And at this time, I'd like to ask John Page if he can come up. John currently is the chairman of the Chamber of Governmental Affairs.
I'm not as tall as Franklin, but thank you, Franklin. Yes, I'm John Page. I am chairman of the Governmental Affairs Council with your local Valdosta, Lowndes County Chamber of Commerce. And to briefly explain that to you, not to take up too much time, but we are comprised of six committees, and I would like to ask the chairman of each one of those committees to please stand. The Transportation Committee, Gary Weisenbaker, Education and Workforce Development, Amanda Johnson, SORT, chaired by Alan Deere, Economic Development and Taxation, chaired by Paul Hamilton, Healthcare Committee, chaired by Ashley Corbett, and Labor and Employment Law, chaired by Trent Templeton. Thank you very much for your service. You can please be seated. Each one of these committees is functioning hard. Governor, we have an active Chamber of Commerce here, and we are very proud of those that are willing to serve. They don't get paid anything to serve on these committees, but they work hard to move Valdosta and Lowndes County forward. It's all about partnerships together across business lines and political lines for the best of our community. We do appreciate our table sponsors, and I would draw your attention to the bulletin. You'll see the VIP table sponsors, and they are Coleman Talley, LLP, Lowndes County Board of Commissioners, the Moody Support Committee, Renaissance Bank, South Georgia Medical Center, Southeastern Credit Union, Southwest Georgia Bank, Spencer Price, MD, Valdosta State University, the Valdosta Early College Academy, and Wild Adventures Theme Park. Please give a round of applause to all these sponsors. Recognize our political leaders and our local delegation. We have Senator Ellis Black, Representative Amy Carter, Representative John Corbett, Representative Dexter Sharper, and Representative Jason Shaw. I've seen several of you here, not all of you. Please stand and let's give them a round of applause for their faithful service. Also, we appreciate our local leaders. We have our mayor and city council. And if you serve on a city council with Valdosta or any municipalities within our county, and the county commissioner as well, would you please stand? We'd like to recognize all city council members and county commissioners and thank you for your faithful service. And we on the Governmental Affairs Council try to work with all of them to do what is best for Valdosta and Lowndes County. But you are the voices. You're the people we need to listen to. We're the grassroots organization that we look to hear from you and then to pass those things to our leaders. We're honored today to have with us Senator Ellis Black, who is a very hard worker. I know how faithful Ellis is, and count him as a personal friend. And he is representing us in Senate District 8, which covers 6.5 counties in South Georgia. That is a large geographical region that he has to cover. And I know that he is out there in several communities each week. Senator Black serves on the Agricultural Committee, the Appropriations Committee, the Education Committee, and he is chairman of the Senate Retirement Committee as well. So let's welcome Senator Ellis Black.
Brought forward by the need, both
astronomical figures that we're fixing to have to spend to build new prisons if we didn't do something. And that didn't show up in black and white on the budget that you can look at. And this is just money that we were able to avoid having to spend. He brought forth this. And when we first started talking about this, my personal reaction was, you know, this is good, and this is going to be really great, provided we put sufficient funds forward in developing these alternative programs to make sure that they are successful. I mean, just turning the prisoners, turning the criminals back loose, I mean, that doesn't solve the real problem. We have developed alternative courts and alternative programs to deal with this, and to save the taxpayers of this state a ton of money. And with this, I'll ask the governor to come forward and let the program be here. Thank you.